those stories tomorrow on Today, so join us then. Now, the flute has really been regarded as one of rock and roll's most popular instruments since it all began in the 1950s. However, one group in the early 70s dared to replace the traditional electric guitar with flute solos. That, of course, was Jethro Tull, and the group's touring Australia for the fourth time. Joan McInnes spoke to the founding member, Ian Anderson.
How different is your music now from, say, 10 or 12 years ago?
The current album we have out is probably a bit more contemporary sounding, which is obviously treading on thin ice because it's probably a little bit too modern for the traditional Jethro Tull fans, but fans of more contemporary, modern, new wave music will probably find the idea of Jethro Tull perhaps too old-fashioned for their taste. So even if we're doing something that's up-to-date music, we have probably just as much difficulty getting it heard as any new band would be putting out their first record. So it's always an effort. Nothing is ever easy in terms of promoting a new record or changing your style of music.
There's been a lot of conjecture about Jethro Tull's signature tune, Thick as a Brick. What does that song represent?
I mean, it was a deliberately fairly obscure piece of continuous lyrics, continuous music, which I don't know, is sort of a progression of, you know, childhood through adolescence sort of thing. There's lots of little recurring themes about growing up. I mean, I can't actually remember all the detail. We still play some of that music on stage now, but whereas I could probably be quite precise if I was actually singing it for you now and say, oh, well, yeah, that's that line and that line, that's what that's about. But it's like trying to remember the lyrics to any of my songs. You know, 2 minutes before I go on stage, I can't tell you any of the lyrics. I mean, my mind is a complete blank. And it's frightening if you actually think about it, because you then have to go on stage and remember, you know, an hour and a half, 2 hours worth of, you know, thousands and thousands of words in the right order. It only comes back when you actually see an audience there and you get that that sort of buzz happening. Otherwise, I can never remember anything. It's horrifying, really.
Jethro Tull fans in the 70s were renowned for their devotion, almost fanaticism. How do you explain this appeal?
Well, I don't really have any idea at all. I think it's a good idea not to know why you're successful. If you do, if you can pinpoint it and know exactly why things have worked out, then it's probably a dangerous piece of knowledge. You're then going to be a little bit more calculated in the way you continue with your career. If you know why you're successful, you obviously want to go on being successful, so you'll probably apply you know, certain rules or whatever, which is, I don't think it's a good idea. I don't know why, just purely fortuitous. I mean, I don't really have the kind of background or the interests that are, bring me close to the kind of people that I imagine we play to. I don't feel terribly you know, at one with the audience, except in the musical context when we're on stage. Otherwise, I don't think I probably don't share the interests of most other people, and I'm sure they don't share mine.
Do you think that part of that appeal was that you played the flute, which is quite an unusual instrument in a rock band?
Yeah, well, it's a pretty rotten instrument, really, to play in a rock band, because it's very quiet, it's monophonic. You have a problem, obviously, amplifying it and pushing it into the arrangement. So, I mean, one of the reasons it's not very often found in rock music is because it's such a pig to play. I mean, there are a lot easier and more satisfying musical instruments to play at those sort of volume levels and in that sort of musical context. The flute's a bit of a struggle to make it work.
So why did you choose the flute then?
I don't know, pig-headedness, I suppose.
Well, the lady's window opened, the dancer candle play.
Great music. Ian Anderson from Jethro Tull talking there with Joan McInnes. That's about it for this Tuesday morning.